See, I'm here with another topic, and what this topic is called electrophilic substitution reaction of aniline. So what we basically are doing, we will be carrying some electrophilic substitution reaction in the aniline, right? But the first one I'll be taking is the bromination of aniline. So let's start there. And this is going to be a bit interesting. Why? Because it has some part that might be a bit twisted to you. So that twist is going to be useful and interesting, as per I believe, right? So let's see what this is and get through. So what you do know is that this is the structure of aniline, right? So benzene, when connected to NH2, this is called an aniline. So what we are doing here, I'm doing reaction of bromine water. I'm taking bromine water here, and this reaction will be taking with the amine here. And what this amine is? Aniline. You probably know that. So what's going to happen, and when there are plenty of bromine here, so this is the product coming out to be. Let me write the product first, and in the later section I will explain why this is. So this is the product you are going to have, and there is one bromine here, the second bromine is here, and the third bromine is right here. So this is the product coming out to be. What this product is called? This is called 2,4,6 tribromoaniline. What if we want to have monosubstituted bromoaniline? Right? Because you got trisubstituted bromoaniline, which is not as useful as the monosubstituted aniline. So what is the method? Right, that's the twist coming out to be. Let me repeat back. When you react aniline with the bromine water, bromine goes to all the three places which are called ortho and para. In case you do not, let me write that. NH2 is highly reactive. This group is highly reactive. What second thing is that, it exhibit plus R effect. So this one exhibit plus R effect, right? This is also called plus M effect. You probably know that. So what happened in plus M effect? Let me write this. This is your, NH2, and it has a lone pair. So what happened? This lone pair shift over here, and this one goes over there. So this becomes negatively charged. Similarly, this one also moves to, something like this. So what is happening? A negative charge over here, a negative charge over here, and another negative charge is over. So what does it mean? Negative charge is on ortho and para position, is on ortho and para position, and that is the reason bromine occupy all the three places. These are two ortho. You need to know this is ortho here, this is also an ortho, and this is your para. So, because bromine water is being used here, so bromine occupy all the three places, these two ortho and one of the para. Now the question, how can we get monosubstituted, bromoaniline? So in order to do that, let's do the, remaining part here. What we need to do, we need aniline. This is what ethanoic anhydride is. So this is your ethanoic anhydride. And then this reaction also need small amount of pyridine, which is a base actually. So this reaction is carried out, you know, in presence of pyridine using aniline and ethanoic anhydride. So what happened here? You do know that these two bonds are polar. So because these are bond, these bonds are polar, one of the bond will break. Let's break this one. So electron will go towards the oxygen and this will become electrophilic while this will become a nucleophilic. Now what you have to do here, what you need to do, you know, I'm just isolating these hydrogen in something like this. So if this bond undergo cleavage, you know, hydrogen will come out as a positive charge. This will come out as a positive charge and nitrogen will be a, you know, negatively charged particle. So hydrogen will go with this oxygen and this will form, this will form ethanoic acid CH3COOH. Just pay attention, this will be a ethanoic acid, while this electrophile will attach to the nitrogen. This will attach itself to the nitrogen. This is what happened. So let me attach them. So nitrogen will be now attached to one of the hydrogen, and on the other hand you have C double bond O and then you have CH3. So this is the product you are getting over here. So after, you know, acetyl group has attached to the nitrogen, you know, now bromine can be easily, it can be easily, you know, substituted, you know, by removing the hydrogen from the ortho position and para position. So now bromine will react and this will result formation of a product like this one, right? You have your bromine, sorry, you have your benzene, then you have concentrate, you have N, then you have carbon with its acetyl group and like this, and you have one of the hydrogen right here. But you have now bromine. Now the question is, how this became possible? Let me tell you. It's because initially this N was highly reactive, but now the reactivity has been decreased because the, you know, the electron density has been taken up by the acetyl group. So the reactivity of amine nitrogen has been decreased now, and because the reactivity has decreased, substitution will take place only at one of the position, and this will be para bromo, you know, while it could also be ortho. So you could have placed bromine not only here, but you could also place it over there, but it will be only mono substituted. But in the last, what happened, let me do this. So this one again react, you know, in presence of the acidic or basic condition. Now just pay attention here, you know, this nitrogen, you know, this nitrogen bond undergo cleavage. So this will come out as a negative charge while carbon will come out as a positive charge. This will be coming out as positive, nitrogen will come out as a negative. So this positive will get with the, you know, negative, and you will have your byproduct CH3. You will have your byproduct CH3 and COH. So one of the carboxylic acid has come out as a byproduct, while the hydrogen will go with the nitrogen. And this way you will get your desired product, which is bromoaniline. So bromine is now here on the second position. So this is your desired product. Let me write this, you know, mono substituted bromoaniline, mono substituted, substituted bromo, bromoaniline. So this is the product, you know, you can obtain. So this was the twist and turn actually I wanted to make you go. Let me repeat back a bit about that. You know, when you react the aniline with the bromine water, what happened, amine group being highly reactive, substitution take place at all the three position. And what these three positions are called? These are called ortho, two of the ortho and one is the para. But this is not what the product we want. So we want mono substituted bromoaniline. In order to do so, we have to start the reaction of aniline with the acetic anhydride. And when we add the acetic anhydride, what happens? The reactivity of nitrogen is decreased, And because the reactivity is decreasing, now bromine will be shifted to only one of the position, right? And that's how you will get the monosubstituted bromoaniline. In order to get what everything happened, you know, you can follow the reaction mechanism right here. But I must complete here, and I say, thanks for watching, thanks for your patience, and take care.